The Rick Smith Show. Now, here is Rick Smith.
So it looks like Lou Dobbs is sent packing. It looks like the Lou Dobbs Tonight Show no longer going to be on Fox News. And Fox is saying it has nothing to do with the lawsuit for $2 gazillion by this company that, look, I got to be honest, the Smartmatic company, $2.7 billion, got a lot of people freaking out. But Lou's being shown the door, I guess. I'm just waiting for Maria Bartiromo and Jeanine Pirro to also be canned because they are also named in the lawsuit. And here to share some thoughts on, well, how far will this stuff go? How much of this lawsuit is going to clear out Fox News? And how many Bill O'Reillys does it take to get to $2.7 billion? Here to share some of those thoughts, our good friend Scott Dworkin, co-founder of the Democratic Coalition, host of the fabulous Dworkin Report. Scott, thanks for taking time for us.
Hey, Rick, how are you?
So that's the question. How many Bill O'Reilly lawsuits does it take to get to $2.7 billion?
That's quite a few. Quite a few. And I mean, the thing is, it's viable. And, you know, they've lost, from what I see, they probably lost countries as clients. So the revenue that you're losing because they cite, well, look at what Giuliani said. I mean, this is straight up defamation, to my understanding of the law in general. Just like, that's why it exists, is so that people can't do this and ruin your company and get away with it. And with Fox News being on the hook here, that makes it really interesting because, you know, there's money involved. There's money to be had. And I mean, I don't know how far this goes, but I do think that Smartmatic's going to win some money.
And now you add that to the $1.7 billion that Dominion is going after. And I keep going, you know, how, you know, you're up to $4 billion. How many Bill O'Reilly lawsuits does it take to get the $4 billion? How many loofah sponges and falafels do you have to buy to get the $4 billion?
Yeah, I think it's going to get worse. You know, there's going to be individuals who have been defamed as well. They'll separately sue. There's no way that they're going to do it just with their companies. Why would they do that? Because personally, they've also been tarnished. And so it's, you know, that whole mudslinging. There's a difference between me saying Trump has Russian ties and he's made over $1 billion from Russians over the past 30 years. Do you want to know why I haven't been sued about accusing Roger Stone or accusing Carter Page or because I was right. I was honest about it and I had the receipts to back it up.
They don't want to go through discovery for you to prove them right.
Right. And so and that's why people are always like, I don't understand why they let you just rip into them or whatever. It's because we always brought receipts and we were always careful about how we said things. But you can't just come back and be like, well, I think, you know, progressives are just, you know, anything that Marjorie Taylor Greene would say, insert there. It's just going to get, I think it's just going to get worse because people, I don't know why people weren't suing under the Trump era. I mean, there were plenty of times where it's like somebody came up with a fake basis of something and they'd ask me a question and I'd be like, here's my attorney. And then they'd stop with whatever witch hunt kind of thing. I guess they were trying to go down that road. It's just like, I don't understand why people haven't sued sooner, especially Trump. So I'm guessing that's going to happen very shortly.
Oh, no, I'm expecting a lot of it. The reason you wouldn't have sued Trump while in the White House, because he has unlimited resources
as
president of the United States. Now he does not. And especially after the next couple of weeks, if this impeachment goes, I personally don't see him being convicted. I see this as an opportunity to get people's stories out and to expose all of the people who created this environment for these crazy people to do the stuff that they did and the people who funded all of this stuff. That's where I'm hoping things go.
And the key element there is without distraction. And so you have people that are stuck at home due to pandemic and you have no Trump Twitter account. You have no Trump in the White House. You have no Trump lifting you up anywhere on social media. And so they don't have that weapon and they have no replacement. There's just no replacement.
They got a replacement. They got Mike Lindell.
Oh,
They
that's
got the
funny.
My Pillow guy. Did
He's
you see his whatever the hell that was?
the meltdown on TV. Yeah, he was trying to talk about the voting machines, and they had to read a statement because they're like, "Well, we don't want to get sued for more money because now you're just like trampling us." And they had to cut his mic. They had to cut his mic because he kept on, "You're canceling me just like everybody else." And then my friend David Hogg went ahead and started his own pillow company. And
And
I think that that's just brilliant because Mike Lindell is supporting all this crazy stuff, and somebody like David Hogg selling it. I'd rather get a pillow from him, that's for sure.
yeah, I said yesterday I will advertise that pillow for free on this show. If it's union made, it's made in the US,
Right.
I will buy one, I will buy a whole bunch of them, and I will promote them at every opportunity.
Absolutely. No, and I'm not. I haven't really gone pillow shopping in a few years. Like, I don't know how that works with folks, but yeah, it is what, what it is right now is people are starting to get their footing. A lot of people were tired after the insurrection and after January 20th, and everything's been going on. I think with the trial next week and some movement of justice in different ways, even small ways, and exposing people and connecting dots, like Roger Stone being in town in January 6th and with the Oath Keepers that was just reported right now. We're talking about, I'm gonna go ahead and say that this trial is going to be about a terrorist attack that was committed against the United States of America by the sitting president of the United States, who knew that it was going to be violent, who intended it for it to be violent, who ordered for it to be violent. And so I think people need to understand it's not just his words. He literally was working with military people, the Flynn brothers and others, to stop the National Guard from coming in, not taking action. So I mean, it was an attack on all of us.
No, I agree.
And so that's what I think what people are gonna figure out from this, and there's not gonna be any defense to this, but what people are gonna have to deal with is that there was a terrorist attack on our Capitol, and it was perpetrated by the bin Laden of this terrorist attack was Donald Trump.
Now, you're right in this. And what I find interesting is this story has now come out about Roger Stone being surrounded by, this right-wing militia group. And you go, and my first response was, of course he was. And my second thought was, he just got pardoned like 2 weeks before, just got out of trouble. Recidivism is high with this one.
Right. I would guess that he came out and wanted a mob and probably didn't want it to escalate beyond that. But I would guess that he was heavily involved. He's been one of Trump's most trusted advisors for over 20 years now. So they've committed fraud for years now. They got fined in New York, in the state of New York, with the largest fine to date, the ethics board, because they had put out advertising that had needles and powdered substance and whatnot in relevance to Native Americans, to attack Native American tribes so they could get casino land. And so it was just basically they started a fake foundation and acted like it was research that proved that American Indians are alcoholics and do all this drugs and whatnot. And they were fined like $100,000, $300,000. So it was a lot of money at the time. So they've done this kind of thing before, and obviously the Brooks Brothers riot, riot. He's done these kind of manufactured hysterics, and I think that we're getting smarter, not catching into it, because there's been so many insane things that Trump's done. Something that Roger Stone does is not like that outrageous anymore. People are like, "Oh, it's just Roger Stone."
Yeah, keep trying. Better luck next time.
Exactly.
This time, good luck staying out of jail. Let's get to something that we're going to disagree on, because I know you're a big fan of going after Marjorie Taylor Greene and expelling her from education and labor. My position has been very clear. It shows what Republicans think of both education and labor to put someone like her on that committee. I think taking her off the committee just gives her more of an opportunity to play the martyr and be the victim, and as she said today, give her more time to not do anything and cause trouble. as where I would have rather had her on those committees. And every time we need to talk about an increase in public education funding, just go, and this is exhibit A of why we need more education funding. Look at this dodo bird. Listen to the craziness that comes out of her mouth. This is, in my view, a Republican problem. The Democrats should have stayed away from it. Now, you can disagree.
I think this is an American problem. And what I would say is to wait until next week for the trial, because there is a crossing of paths here in between why we're aiming for expulsion. There's more to the story. There's more evidence that's going to come out, both video that I'll release publicly and also other evidence that involves her planning around January 6th and then afterwards fanning the flames. She was one of the biggest pushers of January 6th. And I think that her involvement in that will be very clearly warranting of expulsion. And so that's why I see kind of like it as chess. I wouldn't go after for expulsion if I didn't think it was possible. I wouldn't go for after for fun. You know what I mean? Like that. This is not something that I have fun with. This is like the last thing I want to waste my time on is trying to expel a member of Congress and remove them from their committees. But in order to, you know, there's different phases when it comes to these things. So we presented what happened before. We presented, you know, nasty things that she said and done from before and how she defended that now. And that was the first part of it. And that got her removed from committees. And what's next is her involvement in everything surrounding January 6th. And I think that, again, when that evidence comes out, that'll maybe change her mind a little bit. But again, you know, I understand what you're saying. I think that it's a big deal to a lot of people because it's the beginning of some kind of consequence to people that are basically not standing for Americans in Congress.
My problem is, it's not that I'm against the idea of holding her accountable. My problem is I just don't. I know there aren't going to be any Republicans who are going to. There are 11 that voted to get her off the committee. Fine.
Sure.
That was great. I don't see you getting to the 2/3 number to be able to take her off. I just don't.
Well, then, you know, I guess that they're going to be the party of QAnon. And we will, you know, the spokesperson for the party right now is Marjorie Taylor Greene. The person who is the leader of the conference right now is Marjorie Taylor Greene.
Right.
The person getting ovations in conference is Marjorie Taylor Greene. Kevin McCarthy's all over the place. Obviously, she's raising a lot of money off this as well. It's not going to viable Republican candidates right now. And she's raising money off the backs of Parkland students and Marjorie Sutherland Douglas students. And I mean, like, it's just getting worse every day. And I think if we didn't do something now, this would turn into the next Trump. This is exactly how it happened in the first place. And I think we have to confront it. But I think that there's so many people that are actually outraged about it, on top of the people in Congress, that there is a shot that she could actually be expelled. And if the dots are connected there, in regards to January 6th and any involvement in that whatsoever. But again, what I've seen already as of right now is that she should be arrested for incitement on January 6th. She should be arrested for helping to organize it and invite people to it. She should be arrested for helping to plan the hysterics. She should be arrested for doing the follow-up even after the insurrection. She should be, and these are crimes. These are actual crimes. Like, she was trying to incite violence.
Nobody's arguing with that, Scott. Nobody's arguing with if she committed a crime, she should be held accountable. This is creating an environment where she said something years ago. And look, it's despicable. It's deplorable. It's horrible and should be confronted, but not by the Democrats. This is the Republicans that should have had to clean house in this. And my problem is to get to expulsion, you need another 60 members of the Republican Party to step forward to get the 290 number that you're going to need to expel her. I never see that happening. Hope I'm wrong. I hope there's a moment when all the evidence comes out in this impeachment where they say, yes, we've got a clean house. We've got to right our ship. I just don't see it happening. I don't see the Republicans as having any soul left in this. They've sold their brand down the road, and this is the ship that they're on. And so I just don't see it. But we'll see which one of us, how this plays out.
it's not going to take what, what's good about it is a big part of the effort is over with. And so, you know, what's next is procedural. And yeah, there'll be a vote. There'll be presentation of new evidence that we'll present and that the Democrats will present. And you know, we'll see where that goes. I just think that momentum's on our side. And when we were talking about, you know, everybody always said, you remove the cancer of Trump, but you still have remnants always. This is part of the remnants. And we have to, you're right, we have to confront it. We're looking at not, I want to be very careful about how I say this. We're looking at every legal avenue that we can approach to make sure that we can ensure that no insurrection ever happens again.
No, and we agree on that. We need to get to that point, which is why I think this impeachment is extremely important, and we need to have all the evidence out in front of us. And yeah. I want all of those people who wore the funny hats and wore the funny flags and all that. I want them called to testify.
Absolutely.
I want all of it out in front of us, and I want maximum jail sentences. I want a lot of that stuff.
Yeah.
But I just don't see that the Republicans are going to help themselves. Which is why I don't think the Democrats should do it. So let me ask you a last line of questioning real quick, because obviously the impeachment's going to start this coming week. Do we get to move other legislation? Because all that's happened now is we've sucked all the air out of the room for the rescue relief, for any legislation to move forward to help us get out of this thing. Do you see the air being sucked out of the room for that stuff?
Nah, they're writing the bill right now. It'll take them 2 weeks to push that through and get the line items approved. I mean, there's a lot of procedural stuff that happens. And so that bill, the rescue bill, would not be until the end of this month or early March. But most of the programs that it continues to fund do not end in that time frame. So, you know, I think that I'm not going to be able to answer your question, obviously, because it's tough. We're going to have to every day is a battle.
Right.
And we will push in every way that we possibly can to make sure that we can actually get over this hump. I'm tired. You're tired. Everybody's tired. But, you know, the fact of the matter is we can walk and chew gum. We can make sure that we have this trial and also are able to pass legislation at the same time and push legislation on the side at the same time. But I think what's important here is American people need justice.
Yep.
And if we're not going to have a public trial, this is going to be it. So let's make it one. Let's use it to the most that we possibly can in regards to finding the truth.
There you go. Good stuff. Scott, as always, I appreciate the time, man.
Thank you, brother.
Good stuff. Our good friend Scott Dworkin. Quick break. Right back. Stick around. You're listening to The Rick Smith Show.
Remembering that united we bargain, divided we beg. Rick Smith.